What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network reading the Zero Link Bitcoin Fungibility Framework. Chapter 3, Part Z, Stealth Addresses. History. Stealth addresses were described in detail by Peter Todd, and the subject was assigned to BIP63, although it was never published in the BIP repository. The concept was popularized by the Dark Wallet, which combined stealth addresses and coin mixing. The Dark Wallet project ground to a halt despite a couple of attempts to relaunching it, and it remains inactive to this day. BIP47 stealth addresses were proposed by Justin Ranever, described in BIP47. BIP47 stealth addresses differ from Dark Wallet stealth addresses in that the both sides of the BIP47 payment channel handle addresses, detection, and synchronizing rather than relying on any server assistance. Blockchain scanning. BIP47 provides the privacy advantage of the Dark Wallet style stealth addresses to simplify payment verification and other light clients without necessarily to use of a trusted full node. Following the publishing of BIP and BIP47, the stealth address was implemented in the Samurai wallet and have since gained traction through real usage, and over 420 active channels have been created by privacy seeking users. It should be noted that Dark Wallet started work on their own BIP47 implementation during a short period in early 2016, when the project was momentarily revived. Jomian coin joins and stealth addresses. Background. For the purpose of this project of combining Jomian coin joins and stealth addresses, BIP47 could be used. However, Zero Link avoids adding complexity to the premix wallet and aims to use existing production-ready code bases and libraries, and as such, does not want to introduce any significant overhead to the overall Jomian CoinJoin workflow. Therefore, BIP47 is not part of the protocol. Nevertheless, it should be a topic of further research. BIP47 allows for the calculation of two address spaces between Alice and Bob. Alice can calculate the public key of the address she will use to send transactions to Bob. In addition, Alice can calculate the private keys for the address which will receive transactions from Bob. The same is true for Bob vice versa Alice, or vis-a-vis Alice. Therefore, there is no need to exchange or publish individual addresses, public keys, or extended public keys before any transaction. In this way, the individual derived addresses will remain off the radar of blockchain analysis and surveillance services in the event of data leaks. Disadvantages of extended public key-based solutions are: address reuse may occur if multiple premix wallets are using the same extended public keys for one postmix wallet, and the tumbler does not refuse already registered mix output addresses. Address space based on BIP47 payment codes can easily be kept synchronized because there are only two parties involved in any channel and transactions can be followed in lockstep. Extended public keys can leak and compromise privacy. Any party having knowledge of somebody else's extended public key will have complete knowledge of their transaction history and mixing balance. Payment code provides no information about transactions amount or address and use between parties and can be openly distributed without concerns of compromise to transaction privacy. In the case of many continuous rounds disruption by malicious actors, a new mix output address must be registered every time. This requires post-mix wallets to monitor the balance of its keys in huge depth. Payment codes can be exchanged, distributed, and published without compromising the secret and privacy of any individual address generated from the same payment code thereafter. Application. Stealth address generated from BIP47 payment codes can be used within the wallet privacy framework described above. Rather than relying on post-mixing wallet extended public keys, premix and post-mix wallets exchange payment codes and derive addresses on a as-needed basis. Synchronization between wallets is simplified as address look-ahead is greatly reduced. Payment codes can be introduced in the Jomian encryption payload. In this way, the server will have no knowledge of which payment code have been matched with each other. Note that even with knowledge of which payment codes are paired with each other, there is still no knowledge of derived individual addresses or transactions because the server never has any private keys required for address calculation. Since BIP47 payment codes are used to derive compressed public keys, payments can be made to pay to witness public key hash addresses. Xiaomi and CoinJoin's transaction using BIP47 stealth addressing will not be identifiable on the Bitcoin blockchain. Note that BIP47 notification transactions can be ignored for this application. Notification transactions allow payment codes to be communicated encrypted over the blockchain and be recoverable in the event of a wallet restore and the subsequent address rediscovery and synchronization. For this application, payment codes will be relayed with the Xiaomi encrypted payload. If a PostMix wallet loses its own metadata containing the payment code and associated indexes with the necessary information can be recalculated at the next time, if ever the same payment code is received in the PostMix wallet. Pseudonymous repositories. BIP47 payment codes being unique and identifiable derived from the BIP44 wallet seed may be used pseudonymously from a repository of key store and some kind. Such services are being rolled out presently with an eye towards the development of pseudonymous payments, refunds, and mixing. Piers, thank you very much for joining me here in the reading of the Zero Link Framework, the Wallet Privacy Framework, and Stealth Addresses. Piers, thank you very much as usual, and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.